our equipment. Again, this is our future, and anytime we can allow them to vent or allow them to, you know, just put anything out there, we want to be there to support them in positivity. We also want to make sure that we are setting an example for them, letting them know the correct ways to go about properly, you know, conveying the messages out. And he's going to convey his message, and I will hope that you give him a moment to let that out. And then I'll wrap it up.
My name is Kevin, and I'm 17 years old. Again, I'm only 17. This is not my first community event. I've done tons with Ms. Joni and other people within the community. I want to start off by saying I do respect the police, but some of my friends, I'm not going to say they don't, but when we see a police, sometimes we're frightened. Even though I respect you guys, I am frightened. I live in a city, I live by Dunbar, Luther High School, and it's a lot of crime around here. It's a lot. About three summers ago, I've been living around for about 5 years now, about three summers ago, I used to go outside every day on a basketball court. Good men in the community. A lot of people, a lot of young men coming on the basketball court, having fun. A lot of good police riding by. Two summers ago, I started saying less good men. A lot of younger people started fading away. Last summer, somebody got shot on the basketball court. People started coming around. People that I was going outside with every day in the summertime, I come home from school, they selling drugs, not going to school. I asked them, what you do all day? Oh, I was out here selling drugs, trying to get money. Why? Because I need money. You can go find a job. You're 15 and start hiring at 15 years old. You can go get a job. Oh, I want fast money. I need it quick. I want these new joints just coming out. You know, joints, they come out every Saturday, you know, about $125, $50. They want them. They hot. But they don't want. They don't want to earn money. They want to quit. So it does start in the community. It does start with the older people in the community. My mom, she didn't have to tell me to get up and do the right thing. I chose to do it. And I believe somebody up there said it. We have a choice. We as young men and young women, we have a choice to do things. Your mom can tell you not to skip school, not to cuss the teacher out, not to do this, not to do that. But you have a choice at the end of the day. And your parent cannot make the decision for you. They can tell you right from wrong, and they can punish you and things like that. But at the end of the day, parents get tired. Parents get tired, and once they get tired, they deal with it in a way of putting you out on the street. And then you get into the street life, and then you start selling drugs. I had a cousin, he was, I think, 22. He passed away last summer. And just like somebody in here said, it was actually that man over there, he said he was sitting on Instagram, and once you, so I'm sitting on Instagram, and somebody posted Long Live Feast, that was his nickname. And I just broke down. I called one of my homeboys that used to be with him every day. I said, what happened? They were sitting on the front. Basically, he was in the wrong place at the wrong time. And he was the last one to get off the porch. He got shot one time in his chest. That's all he needed was one time. He got shot. The young people that he used to hang around, they was going to school every day. When he passed away, they didn't know how to deal with it. They was hurting. They was hurting bad, so they didn't know how to deal with it. So they started selling drugs, started picking up BB guns. Then, like they said, it turned from a BB gun to a real gun, to then you shooting somebody, then you taking someone's life and you hurting somebody. And just like you said, it all starts in the courtroom. If people don't come out and testify or speak their piece, then they'll just get slapped on the wrist. I know somebody who just got locked up for a handgun and robbery, and he's home right now. And he's home on the box. That's it. A handgun and a robbery, a slap on the wrist, and he's home. And this is and this isn't the first time, the second time, the third time that he's been locked up for a crime. First it started when he was selling drugs, he got locked up. Bullying, robbing somebody, hijacking a car, slapping on the wrist, and now he's home. Had another friend about 2 weekends ago, joyriding in the car. He stole somebody's car, it was a white Nissan Honda or something like that, and the police pulled up behind him. He decides to swerve over to the other side of the street in the wrong lane. So now you're putting someone's life in jeopardy because you want to be stupid and you want to try to get away. Just like people say all the time, you do the crime, you do the time. You want to be a man, you want to go steal somebody's car, you want to do the time. So anyway, he's on live saying all of this. But before he's on live, I knew this because he told me. He's one of those friends that tells me everything. That's like my best friend. I call him like my little brother. He's only 15. And he's spinning around the corner. He crashed a car. Got his homeboy hurt. His homeboy was in shock trauma. He gets off the car, try to run. The helicopter, the bird, is on him. They catches him. The police, I believe a Caucasian police, when he caught him, he said, all I was gonna do was tell you that your left tail light was out. And he said, I don't trust you. I don't believe that. You seen me before. And I ran from him before and I got away. He said, well, all I was gonna tell you was your headlight was out. I didn't know who was in the car. I didn't see your face. So he takes him to, baby bubbles. And he said they gave him cold cut us some chips or something like that. He was sitting in the cell, his parent came and got him. He went to court, they put him on a box, slapped on the wrist. So nothing is really happening. It doesn't just stop the police. I know you guys are doing everything that you guys can, but these guys cannot stop a bullet. These guys cannot run faster than a bullet. My lacrosse coach always told me, your feet cannot move faster than the ball. Meaning, if someone shoots that gun, they're not faster than the bullet. They're not. So it starts with the community. Like I said, my mom didn't tell me to come in tonight. Miss Joni, she asked me to come and speak. And I most definitely said yes because she helped me start my own business. She gave me the knowledge. She pushed me to do my business plan every night, to work on that. She pushed me every night to do my company description. She took me home every night. She was the one that did that. It starts in the community. Just like he said, you gotta go in the courtrooms and speak your piece. Because if you don't, then the judge is gonna slap on the wrist. Just because we're teens, that doesn't mean we have to be treated like babies. We do the crime, we gonna do the time. And I tell my homeboys that all the time. You wanna go pick up a gun and shoot somebody? Just know you're gonna do the time. And you should. I've seen, I don't know how many young men shoot somebody or rob somebody and just get off, and I don't understand. You guys don't understand the hurt that I have as a 17-year-old, and I've been going out in the community and speaking at events like this since I was 14 years old. I see Rest in Peace on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter, Snapchat every night, and it hurts me. It hurts me. It really hurts. It really hits home. And it really hits home around the age of 20 or over. Because like I said, my cousin was shot. That was like my best friend. It really hurts. But it starts in the community like most of these people said. It starts in the community. Thank you.
Thank you.